The term valvetrain in a four-stroke engine refers to the system that controls the operation of the intake and exhaust valves, ensuring they move at the right time with the piston and the crankshaft. To perform this elaborate movement, the camshafts are rigidly connected to the crankshaft. There are generally four distribution systems: push rods and rocker arms, gear drive, belt drive, and chain drive. The chain drive is the most common, especially with dirt bikes. It is so important that all the components work perfectly, all together at the same time. If by any case a single part goes out of sync, you may experience serious issues to the engine. Let's stay focused on the cam chain or timing chain. It connects the crankshaft to the camshafts and allows the synchronized opening and closing of the valves during the piston operation. It is baited in engine oil, so always well lubricated, and operates from the engine crankcase through the cylinder up to the cylinder head to actuate the camshafts. Like all the moving mechanical parts, the multiple links of a cam chain are prone to wear, specifically to elongation. Usually, you can just adjust it with a chain tensioner, but in the long run, this may not work. An excessively elongated cam chain can throw the engine out of sync, leading to potential air risks. At that point, it is necessary to replace the chain itself. Let's find out how to replace it. Let's proceed with the disassembly, replacement and reassembly of the cam chain, specifically referring to the engine of a 2022 Honda CRF250R. When tackling a job involving electrical components, the first thing to do is disconnect the positive terminal from the motorcycle battery to avoid burning any fuses and work safely. Once this is done, let's create the necessary space to work comfortably. We start our tutorial by removing the fuel tank to create convenient access to the top of our engine. Before grabbing the tools, consider that this operation is usually performed while replacing the cylinder, the piston, and the gaskets on the top end. If you want to learn how to replace each of these components, you can find online our tutorials where we show you step by step. Let's start removing carefully the valve cover, the camshaft holder, the camshaft, the chain tensioner, the cylinder head, the cylinder and the piston. It's now time for our worn cam chain. We need now to assess the gear driving the chain on the crankshaft. To do this, remove the clutch cover and disassemble the entire clutch. Once the clutch basket is removed, take off the primary transmission gear, which, once removed, provides access to the cam chain sprocket. At this point, you can easily slide the chain from below. Now, everything is ready to install the new Athena cam chain, designed to optimize engine performance, ensuring precision, silence, longevity, and reliability. The pins are manufactured through a special heat treatment that, along with advanced assembly technology, ensures increased surface hardness and prevents elongation, even in the most extreme conditions of use. Once the new chain is unpacked, insert it from the top, reaching the crankshaft sprocket. Reattach the chain to the sprocket, verifying the correct position of the crankshaft to have a proper timing. Now we need to proceed with the reassembling the entire engine, starting with the piston. To insert the piston into the new cylinder, there are different methods. We always recommend using a piston ring compressor, which allows you to perform the operation with less difficulty and, above all, without risking damage to any component. Close the rings and insert our piston into the cylinder from the top until the pinhole emerges from the bottom. Back to our motorcycle engine. Apply the cylinder base gasket, sliding the cam chain through the cylinder. Position the connecting rod small end inside the piston pinhole and insert the piston pin. Install the new piston pin clips into the grooves. Now we can mount the cylinder on the engine block, remembering to put the dowel pins back in place and tightening the bolts to 10 Nm. With the cylinder mounted, it's now time to reassemble all the components we have removed. As we reassemble everything, make sure to always apply the new gaskets facing the correct side. After placing the cylinder head, remember to tighten the bolts to 10 Nm. We have then to install the head bolts. Lubricate the threads with engine oil and start tightening gradually in a crisscross pattern until reaching the torque specified by the manufacturer, 48 Nm. Another important step is the reassembly of the camshafts and the timing phase. To do this, make sure the timing marks on the cam sprockets align with the camshaft holder mating surface of the cylinder head. Now it's possible to place the cam chain back to the sprockets and mount the camshaft holder, tightening its bolts. Now back to the chain tensioner. Push it back using a flat-edge screwdriver and tighten the bolts to 10 Nm. After this, rotate the crankshaft with two full turns by turning the primary drive gear bolt. Making sure the timing marks align, check the timing phase has been done properly, and finally, reassemble the valve cover. reassemble all the remaining components, including throttle body, fuel tank, and rear subframe. Refill the coolant in the radiator about 1.5 liters. Fill the cooling circuit completely. Start the engine and then wait until it's warm and check the level when cold. So, job's done. This is how you replace the cam chain of a 2022 Honda CRF250R with a brand new Athena cam chain that you can easily find on athena.eu. Don't forget to subscribe to our channels for other maintenance tutorials and to stay updated. Thank you for following us.